A retail bank's customers are households or individuals rather than corporations. And some of the services offered at a retail bank are going to be transactional accounts, which is a fancy way of talking about your checking account, the account where you do your transactions, like paying for things. These banks are also going to offer savings accounts, mortgages, personal loans, credit cards, and debit cards.
A credit union offers the same types of services, but is owned and controlled by its members.
Credit unions and banks sometimes are synonymous with each other, and many times people don't know the difference. The similarities are credit unions provide the same services that banks do. However, the subtle difference is banks are for profit and credit unions are not for profit. At a credit union, you actually are a member and a member slash owner. You're an owner of the credit union. You have a say in what takes place at the credit union. You can be on the board of directors and volunteer your time on the board of directors or the supervisory committee, and your vote counts at our annual meetings. At a bank, your vote doesn't count in that respect.
Because a credit union exists to serve its members, not shareholders, it typically funnels any profits back into providing lower interest rates on credit. If you are a large business or corporation, you do your banking at a commercial bank. These types of banks typically do not handle accounts for individuals. As an individual, you may also do banking at a savings bank or a savings and loan association. A savings bank's primary purpose is accepting savings deposits, but it can offer other banking services as well.
Savings and loan associations are also called thrifts. They take in deposits for savings and transaction accounts, and they make mortgages. They tend to be smaller than other types of banks and more focused on the local communities in which they operate.
With the recent financial crisis, no doubt you've heard of investment banks. These are not banks in the typical sense of the word. In fact, they do not take deposits. They are financial institutions that assist individuals, corporations, and governments in a variety of activities. For example, if a firm wanted to issue stock for the first time, they'd go to an investment bank for logistical help. Mergers and acquisitions are handled by investment banks. If you want to trade stocks or foreign currencies, you could use an investment bank. Orbotics is currently privately held. That means that a small group of individuals own all the stock. If the company continues to grow rapidly, it will, at some point, go public and trade its stock on a stock exchange. Orbotics would likely use an investment bank to raise money through a stock sale. That money could then be used to invest in the company or reward the founders and investors. The last type of banking institution is the central bank. This is the institution which oversees a banking system and sets the amount of money in the economy. In the United States, our central bank is called the Federal Reserve. Most nations have their own central banks. For example, the Bank of Canada, the Central Bank of Brazil, the Reserve Bank of Australia, or the Monetary Authority of Singapore. Central banks act like the banking system's bank.
Individuals and businesses don't have accounts at central banks. Other banks, like retail and commercial banks, do have accounts at central banks.